Can you see it?
Yes.
Okay. My name is Vasily. I'm pretty new to Tango. I met it this spring when I was developing prototype flow control system for the baby Ajax experiment. And lately I have been doing mainly web programming. In this presentation, I will talk about my experience of extending Valve's project with React-based grid widget. First of all, what is Valve? There are two answers to this question. One of them is that Valve is an all-in-one web application that aims to cover common workflow requirements out of the box. The main goal of Valve is provide a neat interface that able to represent states of many devices in the user-friendly form. Valve can do a lot of things. It can represent device attribute in a list view, like shown on screen. It can plot data, different types of data, and also save the results. And here is shown the complete list of functionality. And the another answer is that Valve is a framework for building custom web applications. Valve has a set of pluggable widgets for constructing custom UIs and use modern web build tools. But the most important, probably the most important feature is the presence of middleware SCADA connectors. For now, Valve have only Tango and Tango compatible connectors, but the future plans is focused on an improvement middleware to connect to other SCADAs. This makes Valve's widgets to be universal. My work was the developing of a grid widget. Its interface is shown on the screen. The purpose of the widget is to build monitoring interfaces for device groups mixed with data graphs. For now, grid widget can make configurable interfaces for devices, execute void commands and plot graphs. Each graph can plot different attributes from different devices. For visual difference, you can also set custom colors for each widget. Grid widget is written in React. And so why React? And first of all, what is React? React is a JS library that creates UI in a declarative way. You need to describe the result instead of providing step-by-step solution of how to do it. As for me, it's a superior way to develop web UI. So how does it work? React split application into a set of components. Each component has properties and state as inputs. It also have a render method that which declares how inputs will be shown. Properties and states has a change hooks. For example, for state, the change hook is set state. Each time props or state is changed, it propagate render recall. Components can be nested. State of parent component can become props of child. And the finishing touch is a Redux storage, which is thought of a global state. It has a set of actions that works as change hooks for global state. Each component can access Redux state and actions. The right side of the slide now shows completed React Redux application schema. The same approach is applied to the grid widget. However, here we use Redux only for interacting with the outside world. It can be thought of the state of main component. Grid widget controlled with a set of actions, which is displayed at the left side of the screen. There are some general actions like set state and apply div to the state, and some special actions like set or remove device, set of or remove plots, and configure widgets geometry and color. Now, how to integrate it? Waltz already used a different framework named Webex. It provides its own hooks and state control system. From Waltz side, we have to create three objects. It's a grid view widget, which extends Waltz widget, grid widget, and grid widget layouts, which extends webex.proto.ui. From grid widget side, we created a function named make grid widget that initializes full React Redux stack for a component. And also it provides a grid widget component class that can be rendered into desired HTML element via React DOM dot render function. Grid widget control is split between that three Waltz objects. I hope I represent them correctly. First you create React contacts with grid widget UI. Then you render it into HTML element with grid widget init method, and it works. This slide shows how grid widget code divided into the project. We have a Waltz grid widget repository that contains just a React component and which make it easier to test it standalone. We have a main Waltz project that imports Waltz grid widgets and extends it with custom connection code. And finally, we have Waltz shared libs project that makes it all works together. Since React and Redux libs must be exact same instance, we have to make this project Waltz shared libs. It contains required libs and responds that there are exact single copy of them. We used the Webpack DLL plugin to create Waltz shared libs. This code on the slides shows how to create lib and how to connect it to the project. On the library side, we set the contacts, then set one entry named vendor, which contains all requirements. And to the plugin side, we add Webpack DLL plugin. On the project side, we add Waltz shared libs as the dependency to the package JSON. And also add two plugins, DLL reference plugin with the path to manifest file, and the add asset HTML plugin with the path to the vendor library file. So summary, waltz, there are two definitions of waltz, is multi-purpose web application, and also a framework for build with UIS. And the future plans of waltz is to make interconnection software platform that can operate as an intermediate scheduler. And also waltz can be successful, can be extended with the React components, which is proved by my successful integration. To make this, you have to add waltz shared libs to your React project and connect the vendor library file via DLL plugin mechanism. Okay, thank you for your attention.
Thank you, Vasily, for this presentation. Is there any comments, questions? Nobody. Okay. Vasily, how far you are in the usage of waltz? Do you have already some prototype working, or it's in a development phase?
Yeah, sorry, I forgot about a live demo that I want to show. Yes, waltz is now it can be used. Yeah, you can use it. Actually, I link it to the chat. You can use it now by this link. I'll leave credentials.
Okay.
Yeah, and this is my widget. All this window is waltz UI. This is my widget. So I'll start from the beginning. You can add a device via drag and drop to the grid widget. Then you can set attributes which will be shown. And also you can plot the attributes also via settings. Okay. Yeah, and it started.
Okay, nice, very nice. Okay, so it's a pretty mature product, yeah. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, so who is interested can contact directly Vasily. I propose to continue with the next speaker because the time flies.